गुड मॉर्निंग डियर स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम बैक टू पटेल साइंस एकेडमी। डियर स्टूडेंट्स, एज यू नो दिस इज़ योर शहजाद यूनुस पटेल सर, एंड द चैप्टर आई हैव स्टार्टेड इज़ मॉलिक्यूलर बेसिस ऑफ इनहेरिटेंस। एंड डियर स्टूडेंट्स, इन दिस लेक्चर आई एक्सप्लेन यू अबाउट द डीएनए पैकेजिंग। अबाउट द डीएनए पैकेजिंग, व्हाट इज़ दिस डीएनए पैकेजिंग? एक्चुअली डी एन ए पैकेजिंग इट इंक्लूड्स सो मेनी पॉइंट्स, एंड आई थिंक यू शुड नोट डाउन ऑल दिस पॉइंट्स इफ़ यू वॉन्ट टू लर्न इट प्रॉपरली। या स्टूडेंट्स, द लेंथ ऑफ द डबल हेलिक्स मॉलिक्यूल्स इन अ टिपिकल मेमिलियन सेल इज अप्रॉक्सीमेटली 2.2 meter। डियर स्टूडेंट, जस्ट रिमेंबर इट, वॉट इज़ द लेंथ ऑफ द डबल हेलिक्स मॉलिक्यूल? मीन्स दिस डी एन ए मॉलिक्यूल इन अ टिपिकल मेमिलियन सेल, it is approximately 2.2 meter. remember it, because it is very amazing thing how this DNA is packed into such a small nucleus found in the cell. So the length of the DNA molecule is 2.2 meters generally in a typical mammalian cell. The approximate size of a typical nucleus is 10^-6. Dear students, you can see here 10^-6 m. So this is the size of typical nucleus. And what is this is the size of typical nucleus, and what is the size of the DNA? About 2.2 meters. So there is a big difference in between this 2.2 meter and 10^-6 m. Dear students, then we'll see the next point, how this long molecule can be then accommodated or fit into such a small size of a nucleus. So this is very big or amazing question you should have in your mind. If the size of the DNA is such a long, about 2.2 meters, and the size of nucleus is very short, that is 10^-6 m, so how it is possible to fit or to accommodate this DNA, such a long molecule, into this small nucleus of the cells? So this is very amazing thing. So what to do? It therefore must be condensed. What is the solution? The DNA must be condensed, coiled, and supercoiled. These are the solution. It must be condensed, it must be condensed, coiled, and supercoiled. This is the solution of that problem, how to fit in the such a small size of nucleus. It must be condensed, become shortened, it must be compressed, it must be coiled, and again supercoiled, to fit inside such a small nucleus. So dear students, what we have learned in this slide about the length of the double helix molecule, it is 2.2 meter. Then about the approximate size of the typical nucleus, it is 10^-6 m. And about its fitting into the small nucleus by condensation, by coiling, and by supercoiling. This is about this slide. I hope you are learning, dear students. Now we'll go for the next point. Next point is the packaging of the DNA in the prokaryotic cell. Means in the prokaryotic cell, which is primitive cell, which is 10 times less in development or dimension than the eukaryotic cell. So in this DNA, in this prokaryotic cell, now we'll see how this DNA molecule packed. So dear students, you can note down different points I have prepared for you for this topic, packaging of DNA in the prokaryotes. Dear students, the first point, in the prokaryotes like the E. coli or Escherichia coli, the cell size is almost 2 to 3 mu long. This is very first point, and I think you should note down it. In the prokaryote, means in that simplest type or primitive type of cell, for example in the E. coli, Escherichia coli, what is the size of the cell? It is 2 to 3 mu long. Okay, then they do not have the well organized nucleus, means they are not containing well organized nucleus. This is the important part of this prokaryotic cell, because they do not have well developed nucleus. Then it is without nuclear membrane and without nucleolus, means there is no nuclear membrane or plasma membrane, there is no nucleolus in this cell. So nucleoid is a very small circular highly folded naked ring of the DNA. So this nucleoid means nothing but the DNA molecules in this prokaryotic cell, because cell is not well developed, because it is not having well organized nucleus. So this nucleoid, which is very small, circular, highly folded, it is having that ring, naked ring of the DNA, and this is actually 1100 mu long in perimeter, containing about 4.6 millions base pairs of nitrogenous bases, means adenine, guanine, cytosine and thymine. About how many base pairs it is having? It is having 4.6 millions base pairings. 1 million is equal to 10 lakhs. So this is very amazing thing for this DNA molecule in the prokaryote, as well as it is more amazing thing in the eukaryote, that I'll explain you later. Dear students, what we have learned in this slide, in the packaging of DNA in prokaryotic cell, first we have seen about this part, the prokaryotic cell, like the E. coli or Escherichia coli, its size, what is its size? 2 to 3 mu long. Then they do not have well organized nucleus, means nucleus is there but it is not well developed, or it is not distinct. Then it is without nuclear membrane, but means it is not having nuclear membrane or plasma membrane, and it is not having nucleolus. And then nucleoid, which is very small, circular, highly folded, naked ring of the DNA, and having the 1100 mu long in perimeter, and containing 4.6 million base pairs in its nucleus. So this is about this slide. Let's see some few more points for this packaging of DNA. Like the 1100 mu long, which is actually approximately 1.1 mm if cut and stretch out. So 1100 mu means 1.1 mm if it is cut and stretched. So this nucleoid is to be fitted or packaged into a cell which is hardly 2 to 3 mu long, as I told you earlier. So dear students, next point, hence the negatively charged DNA becomes circular, reducing the size of 350 mm in diameter. Now you can see this size, now it is reducing to 350 mm in diameter. And one more point we are having here in this point, that is DNA is always negatively charged. So this negatively charged DNA becomes circular, and because of this circular shape, its size reduced to 350 mm millimicron in diameter. Then about the next point, dear students, next point is, this is further reduced to 30 mu m. Let's see the next reduction. This 350 mm, now it reduced to 30 mu m in diameter. Why? Because of folding and looping. It means it get folds and looped, fold and looped, fold and looped. Because of that folding and looping, the size reduces from 350 mm to 30 mm. So first it was 350 mm, now it has become 30 mu m. Let's see what happened next. In the next point, this 40 to 50 domains, which is also called loops, likewise. So this is looping. So because of this looping, the size of this long sail, it will definitely reduced. So about 40 to 50 loops or domains are formed in this DNA. And then what will happen? As you know, this size 350 mm, which has now converted into 30 mu m, now because of this 40 to 50 domains or loops, it will reduced again. And what will happen, dear students? The formation of the loop is assisted by the RNA connector. This loop is very important, and this looping is actually assisted by the RNA connector. Then the next point, each domain or each loop is further coiled. Means coiling is again continuous, and after coiling it gets super coiled. Therefore what happened? The reducing size down to the 2 mu in diameter. So you can see here, first size was 350 mm, then it was 30 mu m, then it has become again very short because of this 40 to 50 loops. Then now it has become 2 mu in diameter. Why? Because of folding and coiling and super coiling. Then thereafter, dear students, the last point of this slide, this coiling, which is also called packaging, is assisted by the positively charged HU. What is this positively charged HU? Dear students, here HU means the histone protein, H for histone. So this coiling or packaging of DNA, it is assisted by this positively charged HU. HU means the histone like unit, which is actually DNA binding protein. So this coiling or packaging is assisted by the positively charged HU proteins and enzymes like the DNA gyrase and DNA topoisomerase 1 for maintaining the supercoil state. So dear students, this is about this DNA coiling in the prokaryotic cell. I'll explain it now one by one diagrammatically, but before we go there, let's see the revision of this slide. The 1100 mu long, approximately 1.1 mm if cut and stretch out, this nuclei to be fitted or packaged into a cell, which is hardly 2 to 3 mu long. The because of that folding, what happens? The DNA, negatively charged DNA, it becomes circular and reduced to 350 mm. Then it further reduce and become 30 mu m. Then because of this looping, it forms about 40 to 50 domains. Then this looping is controlled or assisted by the RNA connector. Then this loop is further coiled and super coiled and again reduced to 2 mu. And then what happens? The coiling process, which is very important for this 2 mu m size, it is actually assisted or helped by the positively charged this protein, HU protein, means the histone like binding protein, and two enzymes. What are that two enzymes? DNA gyrase and DNA topoisomerase 1 for maintaining this supercoiled state. So this is about this slide. Now we'll see it diagrammatically, dear students. Here you can see there are
ए डायग्राम, बी डायग्राम, सी डायग्राम, डी डायग्राम एंड ई डायग्राम. सो ऑल दीज डायग्राम इज़ द कंक्लूजन ऑफ प्रीवियस स्लाइड्स. लेट्स सी इट वन बाय वन. सो डियर स्टूडेंट्स, दिस इज ए, व्हाट इज दिस ए? द सर्कुलर एंड द अनफोल्डेड क्रोमोसोम्स. सो यू कैन सी हियर, फर्स्ट इट्स साइज इज 350 μ. नाउ इट गोज फॉर द फोल्डिंग, एंड बिकॉज ऑफ द फोल्डिंग एंड लूपिंग, यू कैन सी हियर दिस फोल्ड्स एंड लूप्स. These are different loops. So because of this folding and because of this RNA connector, as I told you earlier, the size from the 350 μ, now it has become 30 μ. Then what happened? Folding, coiling and super coiling continues, and because of this super coiling and coiling, folded chromosomes, what happens? This loop again become shorter, and its size reduce from 30 μ to, you can see here, 2 μ. So because of this coiling and super coiling, this size is reduced. So each loop is independently super coiled. You can see here there are different loops. Now it partially converts and goes for the different part. For the D, we'll first see partially uncoiled chromosomes, means partially DNA's digestion takes place there. So you can see here these are super coiled folded chromosomes and some are the nicked DNA's, you can see here. So this is that partially uncoiled chromosomes as a diagram number D. And now we'll see the partially unfolded chromosomes, in which you are observing here RNA cleaved. So this is that E, partially unfolded chromosomes, in which there is RNA cleave. You can see here this RNA cleave here. So likewise the size of this DNA reduced because of the folding first, looping, folding, coiling and super coiling. And likewise the size of 350 μ converts into 2 μ. And likewise such a big size DNA, about 2.2 meter long DNA, it get accommodated or it get fit into small nucleus in this cell. This is about this lecture, dear students, and about the packaging of the DNA in the eukaryotic cell. I'll explain it in the next lecture. Till then, stay safe, stay at home, and thank you very much for watching this video. And please do subscribe my channel Patel Science Academy on YouTube, and please like, share and comments for your queries. And please do press the bell icon to receive my instant notification of every coming video. Thank you very much.